How do we increase your bandwidth for wisdom? See, it's kind of like setting your thermostat in your house. When you don't like the facts or the circumstances, the temperature in your home or your apartment, you could do this, you could complain. That's what a lot of people do. That's what many people do about life. They complain, they just lament. Or you could blame the circumstances. Oh, the weather is just making my life miserable. I hear a lot of people do that. You could suffer, you could make a theology about just suffering, or you could include it in your theology. You know, I think God's trying to teach me something. This must be His will that I'm just, you know, I'm freezing cold in my house. Or you could practice escapism. Some people live a life of escaping the facts, trying to distract themselves, going to another party, going to another job, going to another doctor. Maybe it's another relationship. Just turn off all the symptoms, whatever way you can. Go to another doctor and get some more meds just to turn off the symptoms. But my friend, escaping is not the way to go at things. You open your spiritual bandwidth using wisdom like you set your thermostat. You set your thermostat in faith, right? Even in your house, you set your thermostat in faith. You don't feel the set of the temperature, but you believe it's coming. You walk in the house and maybe you've been gone on vacation and it's in the winter time and maybe the house is really cold. You set the temperature at what you want and you do it by faith, because even though you've set it at this very warm temperature, it's not warm yet, is it? But you believe it's coming. So this is how we do the same thing. We use truth to always supersede the facts. Don't surrender, don't succumb to the facts, or build a theology around the facts. Set the temperature.